Okay, we're at Nesscliffe Army Barracks, and this is the first army person we've been introduced to. Hello. 6'7", two bob tail. That's his nickname, but his real name is Terry. If I just show you my height, I'm 5'6". Bit of a big lad.
So Kate's just been found out that she only gets basic rations. Kate, how are you feeling about getting basic rations?
Well, I thought that we'd be going for dinner afterwards. Maybe not like, you know, to a five-star restaurant back in Birmingham City. But I thought we'd all be sat, you know, on big wooden benches. You're going up to the canteen like in prison, you know, when they slop your mash, slop your meat. I thought something like that. But it turns out we're going to be cooking our food on like these kind of camping equipment grill things. But I'm a fan of barbecued food. On Sunday I went to a barbecue, a lovely lamb shank roasted on the barbecue. So hopefully it'll be something like that.
I'm Sergeant Graham Dixon.
Graham Dixon. How long have you been in the army, Graham?
14 and a half years.
Was it a choice that you made yourself, or did someone pressurise you in joining the army?
No, it was my own choice. I always wanted to be since I was a little boy, when I used to play soldiers in the woods, so that's why I decided to join the army.
Where in the world have you been? Has the army taken you?
The army's took me all over the world. I've been Kenya, Belize, Afghanistan, USA, Afghanistan and Iraq. Bosnia, Northern Ireland. I think that's about it, really.
Ever had any life-threatening moments where you thought, this is it, I'm going down to Chinatown, I ain't coming back?
Yeah, I think most British soldiers have had them. But, you know, some of us are lucky and we walk away unscathed.
Closest you ever come to death?
Pretty close.
Come on, tell us, where were you? What was the situation? Paint a picture.
Once we got mortared in Iraq, and the mortars did land pretty close, considering we're in canvas tents.
Yep.
So if they did hit the tent, then we would have been not here today to tell the story, really.
Roll mat, rifle sling, head torch, talc, basher, mess tin, mug, water bottles, gloves, fleece, waterproof trousers, waterproof jacket, combat jacket, bivy bag, sleeping bag, webbing, bergen.
It's chopping hot. Some sort of stew.
Just some of the
equipment on the waist. Has that been cooked?
Yeah, this is good.
How quickly has that been cooked?
Took a little while. Got some meat.
These are some of the examples we've got. Nice, easy stuff.
All right.
If you called wet, and you've given anything to quite easily. Any other questions? Anybody else want to try anything on this on the table? Everybody's sufficiently stuffed.
Fanny, quickly, eat that. Is that better than your mum's cooking, be honest?
Oh no, it's not better than mum's. Better than mine, not better than my mum's.
Such a liar! How much time do you get off when you're in the army?
We get quite a lot. We have 35 days leave a year. My job is pretty lucky because we get most weekends off as well if we haven't got jobs on. We have 3 weeks off at summer and possibly 2 weeks off at Christmas and 2 weeks at Easter as well.
How do you like to spend the weekend? Do you go out and get completely off your face on Wicked, WKD, you know, that blue drink?
No, we do like drinking a bit stronger, right. Maybe JD and Coke. We do socialise a lot in the military, and obviously visiting friends and family on weekends.
Are you allowed to take your mobile phone out with you when you're in the army, like when you're training and stuff?
Yeah, I've got mine on me now.
Have you?
But obviously there is you can't really take them in Iraq and Afghanistan due to the security risk.
What's the mobile phone you have there?
I've got a Sony Ericsson phone, and my work's phone's a Nokia.
Love it.
So I'm not going to get it out because it's quite embarrassing.
Okay, it's quite heavy, retro. Is it? It's probably what's weighing down your webbing.
Yeah.
Love it. How many ways can you kill a man?
I can't really answer that question. Okay. I've never tried, so I've killed a few in Call of Duty, so on a computer, so.
Wicked. This is where Fanny and I are sleeping tonight. No tent, just a parasol. What do you call this? Can you see where Fanny is? Missed him. There he is.
He's got a smile.
Yeah.
So happy, really ecstatic.
Danny, you want to go through what that is? Be back.
Essentially what it is, it's where tramps sleep. Just near the side you can't see, there's a Tesco's shopping trolley with all our possessions in it. The back's where we've got the white lightning and the strongbow. No, it's very good. It could be a lot worse. Could be sleeping with him, he looks like he snores. Or her, she looks
it
like
could
she
be
snores,
a lot
for sure. Check out the knots. Done some good knots.
This is probably the last bit of film we're going to do because there's no light. So there's our sleeping arrangement. Fearny and I will be next to each other. If he snores, I'm going to kick him really hard in his face.
No, we're putting our kit back between one another. I'm not having, you know.
Oh, yes, good shout. Yeah. Like a little kind of divide.
Yeah.
Can you see me? Woo. So. Okay, you're on a desert island. All you've got with you is some string, Pritt stick and a cuddly toy. How are you going to get off that desert island?
I'm going to stay there and cuddle my cuddly toy.
Okay, the island is set ablaze and there's fires coming towards you. You need to escape. What do you do?
I'd probably try and swim. Or I'd try and build a raft.
Okay.
If there was any trees around with my string and Pritt stick.
If the army didn't force you to cut your hair really short, what would be your hairstyle of choice? I'm thinking afro, a white man's afro. Would
yeah,
look
proper
hot
dead
on you.
Long, spiky yeah. at the back, massive sides.
And how much buggery and bullying really goes on in the army?
None, as far as I'm aware. Okay. I've never seen it happen myself. You do see it in the papers and that, the reports, but personally, I've never actually seen it.
It's all good and in your barracks.
Yeah, and there is bullying. Sorry, the army has no tolerance on bullying.
Fabulous.
Or anything like that.
Whereabouts are you based?
I'm based in Stafford at the minute.
Lovely. So, and where are you originally from?
Scotland, near Lockerbie, where the plane crashed many moons ago.
Right.
So that's where I'm from.
Okay, well, thank you very much for taking the time to talk to us, and thank you for looking after us.
Thank you, you're welcome.
Loving the face paint.
Happy days.
Let me just get some on my face. Can it work?
A little bit.
Okay, thank you, man.
We're here on the map, building 109. We're going to follow the road down. Once we get to the cattle grid and the gate, we're going to hang left, follow the road round all the way, and start motoring up to the junction here. Mm-hmm. Okay, then whoever takes over next, we're just going to go straight on ahead, up to CP2, the next junction, and then we've got to come back ourselves, okay? Everyone happy with that?
And we're here at the request of the makeshift government. Tonight, we're going to go out and dominate the ground on a clearance patrol. We're awaiting further orders from our chain of command. For now, we have a route that has been pre-recced by a vehicle and aircraft, and we are now going to go on a foot patrol. We're looking for obvious enemy signs, and direction of enemy threat will be your advance and your axis of advance at all times. The route is down on the map for the staff, okay, and they will guide you around your patrol routes. Actions on white light, as you've already been told. Take a knee close to ground and close at least one eye. Don't look directly at the white light, or you will lose your night vision.
The way we'll orbit. The way we're going to orbit is one basically extended line. So Kate will lead, I'll be behind Kate, and then everyone else, okay? And then Cookie will bring up the rear.
Okay.
Okay. And you ready, Kate? Let's go.
Yeah, man, let's go.
She's going to look like a warrior. She's got a PRR on.